Hello, my name is Molly Urban, and I wanted to share another perspective on leadership today. A question I'm getting a lot lately is how to deal with people who seem to trigger over the slightest comment. In today's economic, political, and social climate, it seems that healthy communication has gone out the window. But what can we as leaders do to help change this? We know that if we simply treat others the way we want to be treated, so many of these contentious interactions would just dissolve. They would go away on their own. But how can we remind others of this simple tool without adding fuel to the fire? A way to help them is to unconsciously confront them. Basically, this is getting them to realize themselves what the issue is or what the answer is, and them change their own behavior without directly telling them what they should do. I had a leader struggling with a team member who would agree to timelines and then miss them without communicating she was going to need to extend the deadline. The leader would directly tell the team member that she was hurting the progress of their projects by her lack of communication, but to no avail. I encouraged the leader to simply ask the team member if they would be okay with others not communicating with her for items that she needed from them. The leader came back to me a couple weeks later and with a stunned look on his face, updated me on how the team member hasn't missed a deadline since. I use this technique quite successfully with my home team, my family. One of my boys began teasing his younger brother, and directly bringing up teasing to him would literally cause him to run out of the room. One day, before their cousin came over for a visit, I asked my son, "Would it be okay if your cousin teased you?" And he said no, and he suddenly stopped teasing his younger brother. I took the younger brother, who seemed to be a trigger for my older son, and removed him from the conversation and focused my older son on something he cared about. I was avoiding the trigger and reaching the unconscious, where his behavior comes from. This resulted in him changing his own behavior without me directly telling him what to do. As leaders, we have the opportunity to help facilitate others to improve their own behavior. When we use our words to ignite another person's own behavior engine and get them flowing in the right direction, they will know deep down that someone was on their side rooting for them. So, how can you help all your teams this week shift their behaviors from a trigger moment to a resilient moment? Thank you for letting me share my leadership thought. Have a great week.